That's a supply and all out of love. You're listening even to the Eleri Sion show here on BBC Radio Wales. And on Sunday night, entrepreneur Adelle Smith from Newport took her bright idea of a children's baking kit business, BKD, to the most intimidating of places, BBC Two's Dragon's Den. Adelle was there asking for an £80,000 investment, but did she get it?
There's a lot of work to be done here. There really
but
is.
I know I can do it.
I don't know whether you can without help.
I need help, yeah.
I know you do, and that's why I'm going to give it to you.
Really?
I'm going to offer you all of the money for 35% of the business.
OK, thank you very much.
I am going to make you an offer. So I will offer you all of the money. I would want 30% of the business.
Well, thank you very much. I'm in shock, to be honest, and I'm massively chuffed. Peter, I'd like to accept your offer.
Whee!
Thank you, Jenny. Thank you very much.
Hey, well, hey! And Adelle Smith is now business partners with Peter Jones. And you can hear her in the background. Adelle is on the line now. Well, congratulations to you, Adelle.
Thank you very much.
How nerve-wracking was it being in front of those dragons?
Oh, it was terrible. It was absolutely terrible. I was laughing then at me saying I'm chuffed.
Massively, massively chuffed.
I must have said it about 10 million times. Oh, goodness me. It was massively nerve-wracking. Oh, terrible.
Well, I did feel for you at one point when you lost your way a little. But you composed yourself and you kept saying, I'm sorry, I'm really nervous. I'm really nervous. But
my mind just went absolutely blank. I was like hyperventilating before I went in there and my mind just went blank. And I was like, oh my goodness, I just need to like get a grip and get these words out and it'll be fine. I managed to recompose myself and it all went well in the end.
Yes, you brought it back, didn't you? And we'll talk more about that nerve-wracking dragon experience in just a moment. Mm-hmm. But tell us a little bit about BKD then. What is it exactly and how long have you been running it?
So it's a children's baking brand. I've been running it for sort of around 2.5 to 3 years.
Listen, are you back in the Dragon's Den now doing your pitch?
Yeah, I know, it feels like it. Oh, God.
Sorry, continue.
I initially started as a bit of a hobby business. So I kind of caught the baking bug with my son and I had my corporate day job that I was doing and I started running events, children's baking events at the weekends. And it took off quite quickly. So at the very beginning, I entered a Virgin Foodpreneur competition, again on a whim. And within 3 months, I was at the finals of that. And I thought, I think I've got something here. People are kind of liking sort of my spin on baking, as it were.
Yeah.
And I kind of run BKD at the beginning for about half a year alongside my day job. And it was getting quite busy and I was having to get people to help me. And then the end of 2014, I quit my 10-year job, which was really scary.
Doing what?
BKD full-time, which is when I had kind of the idea of launching my collection of baking kits as well.
Yes.
Because I thought, you know, it would be good to get something in-store as well as sort of doing the event side of thing.
Yeah.
And then things have kind of progressed since then, and we've recently introduced a subscription service as well, our Mini Bakers Club, which is going really well as well, so... Yeah, it's been a bit of a roller coaster.
So what was your job that you mentioned that you quit after 10 years?
Yeah, so I studied graphic design in Wales. I went to Caerleon Uni and after that then I moved up to London, took any job I could get if I'm honest, because I just wanted to move up, you know, find my feet somewhere else, move out of home. And I fell into qualitative market research. I started at a company. And kind of, I stayed there for 10 years. I kind of worked my way up the ladder. And then by the end of it, I was sort of managing part of the business there, had my son. And then I guess, I think a lot of mums do this. You kind of reevaluate life, what you want to do, what you want to get out of it. You know, I studied design years ago. I've always been very creative, but, I'd kind of fallen out of that world, really. Mm. And then baking kind of brought me back to it. And I saw an opportunity to run my own business, and I thought, well, I'm going to go for it and just see what happens.
Well, that explains why the packaging looks so desirable and classy as well.
That's my husband as well, so he's a designer as well, so he's helped me out a lot at the beginning, actually, with all the packaging design. And, you know, we've had lots of debates, as you can imagine, because I've got very strong ideas of what I like, and
yeah.
He's trying to kind of curb that. And, yeah, that's how we kind of, yeah, we did that together.
So your work and your... Well, the packages and the baking kits that you have, mm-hmm. they're in John Lewis and Lakeland, for example. So why did you want an investor in the first place? Because it does sound that you were doing OK. But you wanted this £80,000 in exchange for what?
So, yes, we're doing well. We've won loads of awards and we get great press and all, and we've been, you know, getting into some fantastic shops. But we're still a small emerging brand, and when we're not Coca-Cola and we don't have their budgets for advertising and all that sort of thing, and it's absolutely amazing how much money you need to kind of get a brand out there and establish it. So, you know, you feel like you're making baby steps all the time, and everyone at our sort of office and our bakery, we're all wearing about 10 million hats. Especially me. So is the investment now will allow us to kind of get the brand out there more, employ more people to kind of take over roles full time, rather than everyone trying to multitask and never really, you know, we're always kind of treading water.
Yes.
And obviously, you know, getting onto Dragon's Den has been great exposure for us. So
okay.
We've had like lots of orders coming through and stuff from being on there, which has been fantastic. And then also, you know, I've got a bit of business background, but I'm not Peter Jones, let's put it that way. And I wanted to get a dragon on board that could kind of help push things forward in the right way and, you know, give me that advice and that help in the background.
Well, stay where you are, because we are going to take you back into the dragons then, because we want to hear about the grilling that you had from the dragons. OK, we'll be back with Adelle Smith after we have a travel update. And here's Dave Brooks.
Hello, Larry. Good afternoon. Looking very busy at the moment on the A4042 just to the south of Goitrus. Some temporary lights and roadworks causing some delays there, so that will affect you travelling between Little Mill and Abergavenny. Very busy still for the 468 outskirts of Caerphilly between the Trekenneth and Cedar Tree roundabouts. Busy too through Newtown on the 483. Again, roadworks causing some slight delays there. Over the last few minutes or so, we've been monitoring two very slow-moving abnormal loads heading west on the M4 to the north of Swansea. Looks like they've cleared the motorway now and have headed off the M4 into Carmarthenshire. So if you are heading further west and if you are encountering any delays, that's the reason. Back to the here and now to Gwynedd. The A470 roadworks continue near to the junction for the 493. And again, those temporary lights causing delays as they are too through Llanrwst both ways on the 470 and Ruthin Road if you're inbound to Denbigh, causing some delays as well. Again, it's all due to lights and works near to the main lights there. And finally, some better news. Arriva Trains Wales. We've had problems today between Hereford and Newport, all due to a signalling problem between Hereford and Abergavenny. That's been sorted, and trains are now running to schedule once again. More travel on the way just before 2.
Thank you very much to you, Dave Brooks. Eleri Sion with you here on BBC Radio Wales. Adelle Smith is our special guest, our first guest this afternoon. She went looking in for £80,000 in exchange for 20% of her company. But what happened? We will find out next. After this one from John Denver and Take Me Home, Country Roads.
Almost heaven, West Virginia. Blue Ridge Mountains, Shenandoah River. Life is old there, older than the trees, younger than the mountains, growing like a breeze. Country roads, take me home to the place. To blue water. drop in my eye, country roads, take me home to the place.
John Denver here on BBC Radio Wales with Eleri Sion, and also our special guest this afternoon, Adelle Smith, who is a successful Dragon's Den contestant. Now then, Adelle, during the process when you were pitching, three of the dragons declared themselves out pretty swiftly, although they were very, very lovely and complimentary towards what you produce, of course. But you had two offers. Peter Jones and Jenny Campbell offered you the full amount. Jenny wanted 30% of your business. Yep. Peter Jones wanted 35%.
Yeah.
So how tough was it to choose between them? Or why did you go for Peter, who wanted 5% more?
So it wasn't that tough, because I had my eyes on Peter, so I was just so pleased when he made the offer. I was shocked. I was like, really? Because I couldn't quite believe it, because, you know, like you said, the three dragons went out and I was like, oh no, it's all falling apart.
Yeah.
And he, you know, he was kind of playing it cool. I thought, I'm not going to get an offer here either. And I had him in my mind because, I mean, obviously Peter's done some great things with people that he's invested, like Levi Roots on the show. And, you know, he's an established businessman. He's got some great connections that I think will come in useful for us, because we're a food brand.
And a baking business,
yeah,
of course.
He's so got track record. Yeah, so it was a bit of a no-brainer, really.
Yeah.
And, of course, there was two new dragons, which just made things even more difficult, because I hadn't, you know, I'd done a little bit of research on them, but I hadn't seen them on TV yet, or I didn't know that much about Jenny. Obviously, I've watched the show since it's been on, and she's come across really well. So I don't think I could have... Either way, I think, you know, I would have been doing fine, and it would have been great, but Peter was like the dragon, so I thought, you know, don't haggle over 5%.
Okay.
Bite his hands off.
Can I ask you then, were you happy to give, you know, when you think of people going in and say, right, I want to give you 20% of my business if I can get this as a return, okay?
Yeah.
But did you have the 35% in your mind anyway?
Whenever you watch it, they always push the percentage up, don't they?
Yes.
So I knew that was going to happen.
Okay.
And I think for any sort of entrepreneur and business owner, kind of giving away a chunk of your business is very difficult. My husband had been telling me for a while, actually, you need to get an investor, you need to get an investor. I was like, no, I'm not giving any of my baby away, sort of thing. But, you know, any successful business, they have investors.
Yeah.
You need a nice lump sum to kind of do the things that you need to do. Otherwise, it just holds back growth. And it's something I struggled with. But then when I made the decision, you know, obviously, I knew going on Dragon's Den I was going to end up giving away more of my company.
Okay. Well, at least you knew that going into it.
Yeah.
Can I ask you then, £80,000?
Yeah.
Have you spent any of it already?
I don't want to. That's the problem.
You've given 35% of the company away. You've got to spend something now.
I'm so used to not having any money. I think now I'm kind of like, ooh, should I spend money on that? I haven't spent a lot, but I have started hiring some new people. So we've got a lovely PR agency that we're working with now, a digital team. So everyone's just starting work because obviously going through all the sort of paperwork behind the scenes does take quite a while. So,
and what about Peter Jones himself? Have you had any meetings with him?
I haven't met him yet. We've had a little bit of an email exchange.
Right.
Because obviously everything's been hectic. And like I said, the paperwork side of things does take quite a while. So that's only literally just sort of gone through.
But he has tried out your baking kits with his daughters.
He has, yes. All the dragons on the show had a little goodie bag from me.
Oh, well done,
So he took that home anyway, and I had some feedback. His daughters really loved it, and then we've sent some stuff since. So Peter had a little bit of a baking session with his two youngest daughters.
Yeah.
And fed back and said that they had lots of fun.
So. Oh, that's good. So do you think, will he work with you face to face, or will he have somebody within his company working with you and maybe guiding you and helping you?
Yeah, so I hope so. Obviously, he's a really busy man, so he has got somebody that sort of helps with all his investments for Dragon's Den, who's kind of my day-to-day contact. I'm sure that me and Peter will meet up and he'll be on hand, you know, if I've got any questions. And obviously, he's got other sort of companies that he owns, so there's going to be introductions there, and to see how, you know, we might work with sort of Red Letter Days, for instance. And he's got contacts, like I said, with Sainsbury's and people like that. So, you know, hopefully down the line, we'll get introductions to those sorts of people as well.
I must admit, I am so, so impressed and full of admiration for you, because, you know, you've been doing this as a working mother. How old is little Kai?
He's just turned 6, actually.
Right.
Yeah.
So, but you've been doing this when he was a toddler, which would have been, well, I must admit, I had baby brain and I've still got baby brain. And to be able to focus the way you have, it's unbelievable. How proud are your family, who are still based here in Wales?
Oh, my God, they're so funny. They're texting me now as we speak. They're all tuned in.
Oh, hello.
And they've all been incredibly supportive. You know, we've had our ups and downs. We've had floods, and I've had my mum travel up from Wales to help to sort that out. And my sister helped me pulling together my accounts information for the den, and my sister-in-law's been put me in contact with people to help me look at contracts. So everyone's like been incredibly supportive.
Oh, you've got a handy little family unit.
I know, I said that to them.
And talking of family unit, yours is about to get bigger because, talking of baking, actually, you've got a bun in the oven.
I have, now I then. Know, my God, the timing's incredible because I've got 1.5 weeks until I'm actually due to give birth. So
no.
It could happen any day now.
Because you were pregnant in the Dragon's Den, weren't you?
I was, yes.
How many weeks were you pregnant in the den?
I think I was about 3 months.
Okay.
So I'd gone for the interview and everything and pitched and found out I was on, and then I found out I was pregnant.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, my goodness me. So how are you going to manage everything?
That's a good question. I'm working very hard at the moment on managing. And like I said, I've got a lovely team here, actually. They're all really competent and on top of things. So there'll be man in the fort at the beginning.
Yeah.
I won't be taking a long maternity stretch, let's put it that way.
Yeah.
Because, you know, I'm in the thick of it at the moment and wanting to kind of, you know, keep the momentum going. But I did it with Kai, and I'm sure I'll be okay doing this one. It's just multitasking and...
Well, you'll have more support now because you're paying people, aren't you?
Exactly. I can actually employ some people to help you.
Exactly.
So that's good.
Oh, well, you know what? We are absolutely thrilled. You came over so well as well, and I must admit, I love the massively chuffed line. It showed you can take the girl out of Newport, but you can't take Newport out of the girl,
Adelle. Very true.
It was fabulous. Fabulous. Listen, stay in touch with us, and We would love to meet you in person, and all the very best with the birth of your second child, which may happen, of course, any day now.
Yeah.
But congratulations to you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Adele. Wasn't she lovely? Adele Smith there from BKD. The packaging is gorgeous. It's black and white stripes, by the way, if you see it in a supermarket near you. And her successful pitch in the Dragon's Den on Sunday night with her kids' baking kits can be seen on the iPlayer right now. Have a look. And I'm sure you're going to be very, very taken by these kits.